Okay, we're gonna start the class. Okay. Okay. Entonces, okay, let's start graduation. That's right. Okay. Okay, chicos, let's start. Okay. Okay. Vamos a esperar a que cargue. Que quinceañera ya hemos leído. A ver, vamos con el siguiente. Okay, let's start with that song. Okay, vamos with the song. Let's start with the song. Let's start with the conversation, excuse me. Okay. Mia and Tina, okay? Okay. The last question was okay. What does Tina's sister wants to do? Some of you answer me wants a party, okay? Okay, what is the problem about this party that Tina's sisters wants to do? What is the problem? The next question is, what is the problem? What is the problem about Tina's party? What is the problem? What is the problem about Tina's party? What is the problem? What is the problem about Tina's sister party? What is the problem? What is the problem about Tina's sister party? What is the problem? What is the problem? Who answer me? What is the problem about Tina's sister party. What is the problem? What is the problem about Tina's sister party? What is the problem? Please read the text. Tell me what is the problem. Lean el texto. What is the problem about Tina's sister party? What is the problem about Tina's sister party? No, no, Sebastián. Read the text, please. Lee el texto. A ver, who answered me? ¿Quién me responde correctamente? What is the problem about Tina's sister party? A ver, ¿quién me responde? Who answered me? Gustavo, what is the problem about Tina's sister party? What is the problem? Could be, Anika. Could be, why? ¿Por qué? Yo te pregunto, Anika, why? ¿Por qué? Why? ¿Por qué, Gustavo? ¿Por qué we can afford a big party? Why? Why? ¿Por qué? Ayúdale a Saori, Jordi, ayúdale a Saori, por favor, a entrar. Dile qué debe hacer. Alondra, ayúdale a Saúl cómo entrar. Dile que tiene que copiar el link y mandarlo a la web. Tal como ustedes me han dicho a mí, igualito díganle a él. Ok, chicos, a ver. A ver, chicos, respondan la pregunta. Answer the question. What? What is a Tina's sister problem? Why? What is the problem? What is the problem about Tina's sister party? Muchos me han respondido algunas cosas, pero les falta responder correctamente. No, Axel, no es así. Lee, a ver. Tina's sister wants a big party, but what is the problem? Very good, Sebastián. What is the problem? What is the problem to make a big party? What is the problem? No, no es eso, no es eso, Sebastián. No, no es que no se pueda permitir. A ver, lee bien el texto, Sebastián. Read the text, please. A ver, el problema está acá abajo, chicos. Dice, the problem is I don't think we can afford a big party. I don't think we can afford a big party. What is afford? four. A four. What is a four? What is a four? A ver quién me dice. What is a four? ¿Y a qué se refiere cuando dice a four? ¿Que los vecinos le permitan hacer una gran fiesta o se refiere a lo económico? ¿A qué creen que se refiere? A ver, dígame. ¿A qué se refiere? ¿A los vecinos? ¿O se refiere a lo económico, que no pueden hacerlo? ¿A qué se refiere con eso afford? ¿De repente a que pueden hacer mucha bulla o que no se les permite? ¿O se refiere a lo económico, al dinero? ¿A qué creen que se refiere? A ver, responda. Answer, please. Ya hay una diferencia entre afford. A ver, les voy a decir, ya présteme atención. Hay una diferencia entre afford y allow. Ambos significan permitir. Ambos son permitir. Ambos son permitir. Pero, ¿cuál es la diferencia? Ay, Jordi, me puse en donde tú estás. Ya, bueno, ya. Afford y allow significa permitir. Pero, ¿cuál es la diferencia entre esos dos? Ahorita les explico. Afford y allow, ambos son permitir. Ambos significan permitir. Pero hay una diferencia entre ambos. Está bien que ambos signifiquen en español permitir, pero hay una diferencia. Afford se refiere y allow se refiere a otra cosa. ¿Cuál creen que sea la diferencia? A ver, díganme. ¿Cuál creen que sea la diferencia entre afford y allow? Si ambos significan permitir, pero ella está usando afford, no allow. Ajá, afford, bien, Sebastián, afford, no, afford is for, is something about economic, afford es para, tiene mucho que ver con lo económico, afford es con lo económico. Por ejemplo, tú puedes decir, no puedo permitirme comprar un carro. I can't afford to buy a car. Puedes decir, I can't. Eso sería el ejemplo. I can't afford to buy a car. Ok, bien, Saúl. I can't afford to buy a car. No puedo permitirme comprarme un carro. Pero allow es distinto. Allow significa permiso, ¿sí? ¿Me entienden, no? Permiso. Ajá. Por ejemplo, tú puedes poner don't allow dogs in the apartment. No se permiten perros en el apartamento. Don't allow dogs in the apartment. No se permiten perros en el departamento. A eso me refiero. No se permite. Uno afford es lo económico y allow se refiere a permiso social. ¿Ok? Ok. Ok, vamos entonces con la lectura. Ya vamos a leer todos ahora. El texto. ¿Me han entendido, chicos? Do you understand me? Yes. Do you understand me? Yes. ¿Me han entendido? Anika, los demás, ¿sí? Ok. Entonces ya saben la diferencia entre allow afore. No puedes decir que no se le permitieron una gran fiesta, es que ellos no tienen los medios económicos necesarios para hacer una gran fiesta. Ok, una diferencia entre afore y allow no es lo mismo. Ok, aunque ambos significan en español permitir, pero no es lo mismo. Tienen distinto uso. It's not the same. Ok. Ok, vamos entonces con me, you, and Tina. Ok, I'm gonna read first and then you have to read after me. Ok, yo voy a leer primero y después van a leer ustedes después de mí. Ok, me, you. Ok, me, you. Dice, read and listen, grammar in context. Read and listen to the conversation. Where are the girls? What are they doing? Me, you. What are these girls doing? Tina. They probably on a sweet 16. It's a typical coming of age party here in the US. Me, you. What do people usually do at a sweet 16? Tina. They do different things. This girl's celebrating with friends and she isn't wearing special clothes. My sister wants a big formal party. She's preparing for it at the moment and she talks about it every day. The problem is I don't think we can afford a big party. Okay? Voy a leerles de nuevo. I'm gonna read again, okay? And then you have to read after me. Y después tienen que leer después de mí, okay? I'm gonna read first, okay? Okay, read and listen to the conversation. Where are the girls? What are they doing? Me, you. What are these girls doing? Tina. They probably at Sweet 16. It's a typical coming of age party here in the US. Me, you. What do people usually do at Sweet 16? Tina. They do different things. This girl celebrating with friends and she isn't wearing special clothes. My sister wants a big formal party. She's preparing for it at the moment. And she talks about it every day. The problem is, I don't think we can afford a big party. Okay, who wants to read the text? ¿Quién va a leer el texto, chicos? Who wants to read the text? I need some of you to read the text, please. Okay, Sebastián, do it. Read the text, please.
Okay. Read and listen to the conversation where are the girls? What are they doing? Me, you. Where are these girls doing? Tina, they are probably at a sweet 16. It's a typical coming of age party here in the US. Me, you. What do people usually do at a sweet 16? Say, Tina, they do different things. Then girl celebrating with friends and she is wearing special clothes. My sister wants a big formal party. She's preparing for it at the moment and she talks about it every day. Problem is I don't think we can afford a big party.
Okay. Okay, y faltó un poquito, no te escuchó bien, Sebastián. Okay, but very good, Sebastián. Thank you very much. Gracias, Sebastián. Who else? ¿Quién más? Who else? ¿Quién más, chicos? Estoy esperando. A ver, ¿quién más, chicos? Aparte de Sebastián. Who else? ¿Quién más? ¿Quién más, chicos? A ver, estoy esperando, chicos. Es puntaje para su intervención oral, chicos. Por favor, participen. De esa forma aumentan puntos también. Okay, Axel. Come on, read, please.
¿Qué parte leo, profesor?
Todo de Milla y Tina, todo, todo completo.
What are these girls doing? They are probably at a sweet 16. This is a typical coming of age party there in USA. What do people usually do at a sweet 16? They do different things. This girl celebrates with friends and she isn't wearing special clothes. My sister wants a big formal party. She's preparing for it at a moment and she talks about it every day. This problem is I don't think we can afford a big party.
Okay, very good, Axel. Very good. Thank you very much, Axel. Who else? ¿Qué más? Hello. Okay, a ver, Margot. Let's start, Margot. Please read the text.
Miyu, what are these girls doing? Tina, they are probably at the other sweet 16. It is a typical coming of age party here in the US. Miyu, what do people usually do at the sweet 16? Tina, they do different things. This girl is celebrating with friends and she isn't wearing special clothes. My sister wants a big formal party. She is preparing for it at the moment and she talks about it every day. The problem is I don't think we can afford a big party.
Very good, Margot. Gracias, Margot. Okay, Gustavo. Vos sigue. You're the next, Gustavo. You are the next, Gustavo, please.
Ya. Ya, profesor, ¿me escucha?
Yes.
Miju, what are these girls doing, Tina? They're probably a sweet. Ay, me olvidé el 16. No.
16,
profesor. Espere. Yeah. It's a typical coming of age party. Her is a youth. What do you usually do at a sweet 16? They do different. This girl celebrating with friends and she isn't wearing special clothes. My sister what's a big formal party. She's writing for it the mom and she talks about it every day. The problems is I don't think we can afford a big party.
Okay, good, Gustavo. Thank you very much, Gustavo. Gracias, Gustavo. Thank you. Okay, Gustavo. Who else? ¿Quién más, chicos? Who else? ¿Quién más va a leer? Aparte de Gustavo. Anika, ¿vos? ¿Quién, chicos? A ver, ¿quién más? Who else? ¿Quién más? Aparte de Gustavo, who else? ¿Quién más, chicos? ¿Quién más? Who else? A ver, nadie más. Anika, ¿me escuchas, Anika? Anika, ¿me escuchas? Anika, lee vos. Te falta leer a ti. Has leído en la primera, pero te falta. Ya, Anika, te escucho. Please, read the text. Anika, read the text, please. Yes, Anika, that conversation between Mia and Tina, please. Yes, that conversation, esa conversación. Okay, Anika, let's start. Comencemos. Enciende tu micrófono.
Hey. What are those birds doing, Tina? They are not there. Probably at a squid. Sixteen.
It's a typical.
It's a. Coming of age party are in the what do people use
16
to add with
16 they do. Okay, Anika, tu micrófono se va. Okay, sería bueno que lo ajustes. Veas tu micrófono, Anika, ¿me escuchas? Sería bueno que lo arregles bien tu micrófono, Anika. Se te va la voz, Anika. ¿Sí? Okay. Sería bueno que arregles tu micrófono, Anika. Okay, okay. Okay, vemos aquí, chicos. Pueden ver esta imagen. Acá la ven a Nick y sus amigas. Y aquí hay esta imagen. What do you see in this picture? What do you think is this picture? ¿Qué creen que sea esta imagen de acá arriba? Ah. No, Anika, no se te escucha, no se escucha nada. Arregla tu micrófono, Anika. Ok, chicos, vemos aquí la imagen de ella, de esta chica, ¿ok? What is she doing? ¿Qué creen que le están haciendo a esta chica, chicos? What are they doing to this girl? What do you think is? A tradition, maybe a tradition, no? Could be a tradition. A party is more than a party. Es más que una fiesta, chicos. It could be, but it's a tradition. Si miran abajito dice Miyu, dice why do they? ¿Cuál creen que sea lo correcto? Aquí le han puesto what, why are they painting this girl's face? Miyu le dice a Tina. Miyu said to Tina, why are they painting this girl's face? ¿Cuál es la respuesta de Tina? ¿Cuál creen que sea la respuesta de Tina? Don't know, I know knowing. A lot about Native American tradition. ¿Cuál creen que sea la respuesta correcta? Don't know o I know knowing. Donde dice Tina. What is the right answer? Don't know o I know knowing. Are you sure knowing? Piénsenlo bien, chicos. Don't know. No, generalmente no va con ING, al menos que sean casos especiales, que ya les voy a enseñar más adelante. Es I don't know. I don't know a lot about Native American tradition, but I think she's. ¿Cuál creen que sea la respuesta? What is the right answer? She's preparing or she prepares? She's preparing or she prepares for the sunrise dance. It's a coming of age ceremony for Apache girls. What is the right answer? Preparing or prepares? Preparing, okay. But I think she's preparing. Bien, very good, she's preparing. But I think she's preparing for the sunrise dance. It's a coming of age ceremony for Apache girls. What is the name of the coming of age ceremony for Apache girls? What is the name? What is the name of coming of age for Apaches girls. Apaches girls. What is the name of coming of age for Apaches girls? Tell me. What is the name of coming of age for Apaches girls? A ver, ¿quién me dice? Who told me? Who tell me? I said. What is the name of coming of age for Apaches girls? No. Look here. Miren abajo. Ya no estamos en el texto de arriba. Miren abajo. For Apaches girl. What is the name? It's a tradition. What is the name? The name of the tradition of coming of age for Apaches girls, Apaches, for Apaches girls, for Apache girls. No, miren el texto. What is the name of the tradition or ceremony? What is the name of the ceremony? What is the name of the ceremony? Very good, Sebastian. Very good. What is the name of the ceremony? What is the name of the ceremony? Very good, Sebastian. What is the name of the ceremony for coming of age? For coming of age for Apache girls. What is the name of this ceremony? This is right. Está arriba, chicos. Please look the text. Solamente uno me ha respondido el nombre de esa fiesta, de esa tradición de los apaches. Solo uno me ha respondido. Nadie más. A ver, después me responden, chicos. A ver, díganme, mientras voy tomando. Está arriba, chicos. ¿Qué pasó, Anika, los demás? ¿Cómo se llama esa fiesta? What is the name of this ceremony? Está arriba. Cuando dice, she's preparing for the sunrise dance, it's a coming of age ceremony for Apache's girl. Ahí está arriba. Ahí está el nombre de esa ceremonia. Ay, chicos. Ya voy tomando la asistencia, ¿ya? Alondra, Alonso, Anika, Axel, Esaú, Gustavo, Jorge, Kevin, Luis, Margot, Melanie, Miguel, Sebastián, Sofía, Jerry, Alejandra, Jordi. ¿Alguien más falta nombrar? ¿Alguien no le he dicho, chicos? Todos están, ¿no? La siguiente clase vamos a leer esta parte del texto, ¿ya? Ok, chicos, si no hay nada más, entonces podemos despedirnos. See you next class. See you next class.